Wow, it's super slippery because of this kind of sand. Oh man! What are we getting ourselves into? Oh.
Good morning, people! It's 8:30 in the morning, and welcome to San Jose del Guaviare. This place is known to be the gate to the Amazon region. So basically, this is where the Colombian wetlands end and where the Amazon region start. We're gonna be spending here a couple days. We're staying at a hotel just around the corner, and we got our bikes parked at this local parking spot. And we're gonna take 2-3 days, maybe four, who knows, to explore this region and to discover all the places that this place has to offer.
We need to find a gas station before heading out to explore. Buenas! Te cancelo lo de las dos motos. Diez, de esa. The guy at the hotel was shocked when he saw us coming out of the room with all these clothes like that. He told us basically we were committing suicide with all these clothes and the heat. It will be impossible to walk to the sites like that. So we told him not to worry. We brought extra clothes to get change for the walk. 16,100 pesos for a gallon of gas. We're gonna be heading out of town now. The place we're gonna be stopping at first, it's not really far away. It's just about 20-25 minutes away from here, but we gotta walk from there. From what I understood, you park the bike somewhere and then you have to walk to visit the site. So we'll see how we're gonna do with this heat. Normally when people come visit this region, they do it with an agency, but right now we are basically exploring by ourselves. The road is okay for a motorbike. Normal cars cannot get on the road we're gonna be taking today. The place where we are right now, San Jose del Guaviare, used to be a no-go zone for decades. This place was controlled by the guerrilla for over 30 years. And in 2016, when the peace agreement was signed between the government and the FARC, this place became quite safe. Now it is visited by many people, foreigners and locals alike. For me, it's unimaginable to think that this place could not be visited before. The main business here before used to be the coca. Farmers here grew coca on their lands. They needed about an hectare of land to provide for their families. But nowadays, it's not the case. The main economy here is the cattle business and, of course, tourism nowadays is picking up. The problem with the cattle is that farmers now, instead of 1 hectare of land, they need 20 hectares of land to provide for their families. And the cattle does not belong to them, so basically they just rent the land and that's how they earn money. It's not enough, and that's causing also a lot of deforestation in this area. Our first dirt road of today. I wonder what the green thing is. Yesterday and this morning as well, when we were walking around town, we saw a group of kids, actually many groups of kids and some adults as well, who are part of an indigenous community of this area. They're called the Nukak. those indigenous people used to live in this land, not in the city, but far away in the jungle. And because of the violence in this area, they were forced to leave their homes, and little by little, they're coming closer to town. And in the town, the kids, I felt a little bit bad, but the kids were asking for food, for money, and they, I don't know, I'm not sure if they speak Spanish or not, and if they understand maybe a little bit by now, but when they were talking to us, they didn't speak Spanish at all. So yeah, I think that shows like the impact of the violence in the area, not only the impact that this violence has had towards civilians, but also towards these indigenous communities here. This is where we leave the main road behind and we get on this smaller road. There are many beautiful rivers around this area, but it's the dry season right now, so I'm not sure if we're gonna be able to like go for a swim and or see any waterfalls at all. The guy at the hotel told us it was really not worth it, but we still wanna give it a shot, you know, to see what we find. Oh, it's super slippery because of this kind of sand. That's where we're going. At least there are signs on the way. This is, it wasn't this way. Where did Kaito go? I think it's better to go to the right. Too much sand. So I guess this is where we park and we start walking. Buenas. Para ir a Puerta Orión, ¿se puede parquear aquí? ¿Desde dónde se entra?
Sí, de acá.
Somos dos. Sí.
Sí, acá tienen que hacer el ingreso y ahí van con un día.
Ah, ok. ¿Qué vale el ingreso?
35 con pareja.
The place where we're walking right now used to be all covered by the sea. So the rocks you see here on the background were all covered by the sea, and apparently those lines, those marks over there used to be where the sea reached. So when the sea, when the waves hit the rocks, they left these kind of marks on the rocks. And these rocks are very delicate, so the sand you see here everywhere and on the road coming this way is because of the erosion of these rocks. So these are like sandy rocks, they're very delicate, so that's why we cannot climb on top of them. All of these sand you see here are part of the rocks. This is what they're made of.
ビーチにいるみたいですよ。砂の感じが本当にサラサラしてるんで。 Is it jungle here? Yeah, right?
Yeah, this is the beginning of the Amazon region.
すごい。これが熱帯雨林の環境なんですね。Wow.
I see.
ジャングルってもっとすごいこうジメジメしてすごい暑いイメージがありましたけど、一回中に入るとまったくそんなことはないです。むしろ涼しいです。ジャングルの中にはもしかしたら場所によって違いがあるのかもしれません。This
is called the Jaguar Cave.
Eso tiene por ahí entre unas
20-30 metros de hondo.
What an incredible place. Like, honestly, this forest is not even that old. We just learned this used to be all for cattle here, and they used to burn all these fields down for the cattle. And that was until 2005. So it is very, very recent. And this forest has grown basically thanks to the bats, because apparently they grab the fruits and the seeds from the palm trees around here, and when they fly, they drop it somewhere, and then new palm trees are growing on top of the rocks. It's the same like everywhere around here. You guys might be wondering what happened to my lip right here. Well, it turns out when we were in Tatacoa Desert, I got a sunburn, and then I got a blister, and now this is what it looks.
これ木の根っこらしいですよ。
あの上に木が生えてるんで、その根っこがこう来て、
こうやってぶら下がってます。あの、映画のプレデーター皆さん知ってますか？プレデーターのこの髪の毛のところみたいな感じになってます。わーお。
Made it to the Orion Gate. It's this one right over here, this beautiful rock formation over here. And it was given that name because apparently in December you can actually see the Orion constellation across the whole of this rock. If you're standing over there, you can see it from that hole on this side. ¿Cómo era acá cuando estabas creciendo?
Había guerrilleros. Y nosotros convivíamos con ellos normal, eso no pasaba nada. Pues el que tenía problemas con ellos, pues ya como todo.
Claro.
Y pues aquí en el pueblito duramos, cuando me acuerdo tanto, que duramos como 3 días para llegar, porque la carretera era horrible. Yo estaba y me metía por un lado, por otro, por un ferry, por el río. Entonces la llegada fue bastante dura y ya después pues fue creciendo. Allá se ve San José.
Sí.
Ya San José siempre es grande y ya pues el tema de lo que es la seguridad de todo pues está como calmado, ¿no? Es muy malo, entonces sí, ya se pueden ir a Guaviare a hacer turismo cuando quieran.
We're trying to find a river where we can swim. We're in the dry season right now, so most of the rivers are all dried, unfortunately. The guy at the previous place recommended at this place, so we're gonna go out and check it out to see if it's worth it or if there's really no water. Charcolandia, yeah, that's the place. Wow, it's dusty! Wow, man, I almost fell here. There are like deep pools of sand all of a sudden. Shoot, man. A bridge in the middle of the jungle. Oh, the water doesn't look very nice down there. What a change, man. What's this? It's super rocky. I think it's... Yeah, I think it's straight, yeah, that way. Ooh. すっげえじゃん, これは. Ooh. Man. Ooh. I gotta say, it's my first time riding in such conditions. Oh. What are we getting ourselves into? Oh man! What did we get ourselves into? Oh. No way! No way! It says it's closed because it's summer time. We came all the way here. Yeah, so you guys, yeah, the summer season makes this place dry. There's someone selling pineapple here. Let's see if we can buy like a piece of pineapple or something. Buenas. ¿Usted ven aquí como la porción de piña?
Tiene la porción de piña, se vende guarapo de piña, vende preparada de naranja, jugo de naranja, preparada de sandía.
Nos regala una, por favor. ¿Y esta piña la cosechan aquí en la zona?
Sí, claro, en la piña. Los cultivos grandes están por ahí, ya.
Ok.
このグアビアレ川沿いにはたくさんの店が並んでて、まあ、主にはバーなんですけれども、さらに川沿いが砂浜になっててビーチのような感じになってます。そして皆さんがこう遊歩道みたいになってるんで、まあ、みんなが飲んでね、楽しんでる感じになってますよ。すごく居心地のいい場所です。
The guy here has installed these three boats for people to get across. It's 1,000 pesos to get across this bridge. There is some sort of beach on the other side. It looks pretty cool from up there, so we're gonna go and check it out.
今寒気でここの今僕たちが歩いてる場所は水が干上がってますけど、多分雨季の時はこれがもういっぱいになってここも歩ける状態ではないだろうし、あの橋も多分渡れなくなると思います。すごいです。まるでビーチです。ここはアマゾンのビーチです。